These structural characteristics cause oligopolies to exhibit a rather interesting behavior. They are interdependent. Because there are only so few firms under oligopoly, each of them has to take account of others. And this means that they are mutually dependent. They are interdependent. Each firm is affected by its rival's decisions. Now, if a firm changes the price or the specification of a product, for example, or the amount of advertising, the sales of its rivals will be affected. The rival may then respond by changing their price, their specification, or their advertising. So no firm can afford to ignore the actions or the reactions of other firms in the industry. So this causes two kinds of behavior to merge. They can either be friends or they can fight. So it can either be competition or collusion. The interdependence of firms may actually make them wish to collude with other people, to gang together and act like as if they were a monopoly, to make friends, and eventually to maximize industry profits. At the same time, they'll be tempted to compete with each other to fight, and either in price or non-price factors, to gain a bigger share of the industry profits for themselves. So it's really like a bunch of kids playing in the playground. You know, they either fight or they make friends, and then they make friends and then fight again. So these two policies are incompatible with each other. You can't make friends and fight with someone at the same time. And the more fiercely the firms compete to gain a bigger share of the industry profits, actually the smaller the industry profits will be. For example, price competition will drive down the average industry price, while competition through advertising will just waste everyone's money. Either way, industry profits fall.